Somebody say King Kev once. Good talk. Good vlogs. Good vlogs. And guess who I seen in the beginning? Guess who I seen in the beginning? Shout out Puerto Rico. Shout out Puerto Rico. Yeah, but we find out in the beginning. Look at this. Look who we find. This is courtesy of Hood Blog News. Look at the odds of this. I knew the Most High had us this morning. But what are the odds of this? And this guy being on Firebug's Instagram. Now, he got all type of tattoo. But you can't see that in the photo because he covered up so much. Now, let's see which one of y'all want to call me in. We got a predicament here. We got Firebug Storm with his friend who's at the scene of crime. (424) 209-9506 The people champ is available for conversation. This is the same guy. This is the same guy. I won't hear nothing about nothing if you ain't talking about nothing.
So, and you a dude, man. You said I was cutting everything the same way. My thing is, I'm going to lay out the connections of all these connected, right? Okay. David Gross.
Go ahead.
Is, David Gross is from neighbor, from Inglewood.
Go
he
ahead.
Speaks on the complex video, and in the complex video, he speaks on more than he goes to Woodland. And Sean Mack is like, okay, Sean Mack claimed that Sean Mack is the Inglewood version of Missy.
Go
and
ahead.
That makes present. Okay. And on top of that, I'm kind of all over the place. But
take your time. It's all over the place here. We receive it, and then it's broken down in our whole minds in due time. Go ahead, bro. You good.
Okay. So, on top of that, if you look at the Jack Stone video, which came out in 2017.
Wait, Sean Mack passed away?
Yes. He got killed.
Really?
Yeah, he got killed in the neighborhood. And if you watch the video, Slide Back, which came out in 2017, it's the whole situation was somebody got killed from the 60s side. And they said, and even the video, they could pick Sauce and Bruce being a witness, right?
Witnessing
the murder that happened in the 60s. In my mind, I want to say that was fascination.
Go ahead.
Right here. Okay. Okay. So, Jack Stone, I'm going to get a hat on with the love, with the four.
Yeah.
Not a man, but with the four. With the
Milwaukee.
Milwaukee. Yeah,
Milwaukee. Right, go ahead. Go ahead.
I'm the neighbor myself, but I gotta go on. I'll listen to that.
You saw I'm the
okay.
Because I know. Go ahead.
Okay, so even in the video, it shows the homeowner from the 60s, they stole, and the girl had been in the hood. They told him, everybody in the guy already. The girl walks up to the dude, puts the gun up under the neck, kills him. So everybody runs off. And it's one dude that's looking like Sean Mack, which Sean Mack had a beard. He runs towards the back of the house. Jay Stone and the dude with the Milwaukee hat. He runs. They run and chase dude down and guns him down in the backyard. If you watch Rucci, the dude Rucci, he's also from Neighborhood Power Room. Neighborhood Power Room. He depicts and he shows the spot where Sean Mack was killed. Which if and he showed it and it's in the backyard. Okay. Okay.
So another
part. They guns him down.
Go ahead.
Okay, another thing that I also want to say that Firebug slipped up and said in his interview, he said, hey man, I can walk out of my front porch and look up the street and see nipping all them up
yeah.
The time.
Yeah.
Then I can look down the street and see homeboys and all that, right?
Yeah.
Okay, now that's on a good, you just on a good point when you said, it seems like Firebug's whole story matches exactly up, exactly with City Cub story. They was out trying to go get something to eat with a homegirl. The homegirl got scared, instead the homegirl got scared when they pulled up. So they parked around back.
It had to be with another guy. RZA Islam said it was two shooters in and out fast.
But you realize that
that's where they comes in.
Oh, look. Rucci looks Mexican because he's half Mexican. The old dude is Taco from neighborhood Inglewood family.
Go ahead.
He's half Mexican. So it could have been possibly them. I stand on the fact that I know since the beginning, after I passed the Chrissy bullshit, I said, man, this is some bullshit shit that went down. My only thing is, I figure out they go this way. And for the American, that's the point. Everything else
I don't know if that's staged or what. Maybe they did it for not to look like gang.
Trying to ease the retaliation shit.
Because the average person, let me put this out on. The average person in LA ain't no goddamn gangbanger. So all that, you let them just let it be and report the news. They killing each other. I don't even know. Sticks been coming up here. Oh, we gotta, we can't allow this. This will be war. No,
they go back to that property too.
Go ahead.
To that, they go back to the property too, where that could be a reason why the grocery side pulled the car. And say, no, we're sitting down building all this.
That's right.
It could have stayed there, so that's the reason why they took the store down.
That's the reason. It could
have been. So he could get that. Dude,
Nipsey
on that
felt
conference.
So uneasy with him. It was like, what the fuck? So, but go ahead. I'll let you.
Look, dude is from, David Gross is from
Inglewood. So that's why Nipsey knew. That's why it was a meeting of God, because they knew where Nip was. They knew he was Firebug there and this other.
I believe David Gross might have been possibly. If somebody called Nipsey out to the store, if that's what they're going to go with, that's what
that
they're going to David Gross
and Bloods, and these Bloods are affiliated with, and this makes perfect sense why they would be covered up at such a high level. This man is affiliated with all levels. Everybody out there hit that like button.
Yes. Kev wrote, I'm telling you.
I love that.
But I ain't even tripping on, like, your boy Lil Kev, man, he be throwing it off because he be tripping off stupid ass shit, like tennis shoes and shit
that's
like that.
They
don't have nothing to do with
see, these guys are there to cause confusion.
That's what I believe.
They are there to cause confusion, to take my information and send it into a whirlwind of conspiracy. They can't even contend with this no more because we coming with live discussion fact. We coming out to fact. They're adults, real supporters of the show to say, wait a minute, this makes perfect fucking since
Firebug was a known shooter.
Yeah,
a known shooter.
Like
you really believe that Nipsey, even in that conversation, me being of the streets and did my thing out here in the streets, I see an enemy and it's in the quarter spot that we can't even do what we was trying to do. That's what behind that makes sense legal what he said with Nipsey said it's Firebug, right? Oh, okay, yeah, Firebug, you know all this stuff on the South they got a man that sounds like a beast with. We got to know that ass nigga that was up. You know what I'm saying?
Right.
And he took that and he took it up and he tried to link up with him again. All that trying to link up later on today, that was some bullshit.
That's bullshit.
And somebody else put up on the Be Safe video. At the end of that Be Safe video, Firebird got the second to the last verse. And on that verse, he say something, he speak on Nipsey's name and he laughs about it. And then in the background, in the ad libs, he bang, and he be like, yeah, this is the like, you know what I'm saying? I know this shit.
Yeah,
I know what's up. Like, he let Nipsey know, yeah, nigga, that's it. Oh, yeah.
What's the name of his song?
Be Safe.
Thank you, sir.